The NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory is famous for the Mars Exploration and Curiosity rovers, the Voyager program, and countless other history-making missions. But behind all those mind-blowing events are IT systems enabled by the cloud, analytics, big data, and consumer devices. JPL's cloud strategy includes a public, private, and hybrid cloud that will run from a single data center and power all the organization's missions into space. For employees working on missions, the cloud gives JPL the storage and flexibility it needs without disrupting workflow.
One of the things that in our hybrid cloud that's going to make this so different for people and is making a difference is on mission work, to be able to, you know, provision what they need. The compute and storage resources they need as they need it is enabling these mission folks to be able to work differently than they ever have before.
During the launch of the Mars Curiosity rover in 2011, JPL used Amazon's cloud to send out pictures and stream live video to the 12 million people watching the event.
That taught us a lot of lessons. So we now know how to balance our workload, expand our workload based on need, and we really understand content distribution when you need to have it across the world. And so I think we can take advantage of those for our next encounters and missions, and whether it's Mars or whether it's Saturn or any other planet that we have some encounters around.
Coming up early next year will be the launch of the Soil Moisture Active Passive Satellite, which will monitor water and energy and help improve flood predictions and drought monitoring. SMAP will use a special analytics cloud to enable workers to analyze data points without disrupting the mission.
They have access to 3 billion data points that they can manipulate and look at. And once the mission takes off, now they can compare what it looks like when it's flying to what it did on the ground. And that's only possible because we had access to the cloud.
The IT department at JPL also gives flexibility to employees in other ways. They are toying with a concept called Brain 2.0, where they imagine employees, enabled by technology, would have uninterrupted think time in creative spaces.
JPL gets some brilliant people, really, really smart people. And today, they get 400 emails a day. They are distracted every 5 seconds with bells ringing, meeting reminders, etc. So what are they not able to do? They're not able to get think time. I think best in front of the Christmas tree at New Year, or over Christmas when everybody's asleep. That's when my ideas come. His come on the beach. So with the Oculus Rift, could you simulate that environment and enable people just to think? Then, once they have an idea, what do they do? How do they communicate? Well, they can just speak it, and Siri will pick it up, or Google Glass will pick it up. But it's all focused on the person. And we think that's an interesting way of looking at it, and it's going to change the way we work.
JPL also has what they call an IT petting zoo, where employees can tinker with new consumer technologies like Google Glass, 3D printers, or Oculus Rift, as well as collaborative workspace called The Hub. The Hub has modern style couches and chairs and group workspaces, as well as an IT information desk and various technologies to play with. Any JPL employee can go there at any time to get away from their desk, get some inspiration, or meet privately with team members.
We see that as a benefit for JPLers not being stuck in offices or cubes. They can get out and work where the work is versus where the IT is.
This is Lauren Purcell for CIO.com.